Hello, and welcome to the second video in our Open Education Drops, created by the European Network of Open Education Librarians. Today, we'll be talking about what it means to be open and how it differs from free, digital, and online. Let's start with free. There are a lot of free materials and tools available on the internet. It means or implies that there is no cost in accessing the material. Often, it means that use is limited to just that, access only. It may not be free to reuse, change, or share with others. Open means not only free, but that the author of the work gives permission to others not only to access, but to reuse, revise, remix, redistribute, and retain at no cost. This permission is given by means of an open license, such as those defined by Creative Commons. David Wiley has named five activities that are allowed under open permissions, and they are as followed. Number one, retain. This is the right to make, own, and control copies of the content. Number two, reuse. This is the right to use the content in a wide range of ways. For example, in a classroom or in a study group, or maybe on a website or in a video. Number three, revise. This is the right to adapt, adjust, modify, or alter the content itself. For example, translate the content into another language. Number four, remix. The right to combine the original or the revised content with other open content to create something new. For example, a mashup. And number five, redistribute. This is the right to share copies of the original content, your revisions, or your remixes with others. You can, for example, give a copy of the content to a friend. As well, something that is free, obviously, does not need to be digital or online. Typically, open means both, as these technologies reduce geographical cost barriers to access to education and educational resources. However, you can, for example, print those materials and have a tangible, offline, no power needed copy. Let's move on to digital. Digital can refer to an electronic version of a physical document. For example, something is created in paper form, can be digitized and turned into a PDF. Sometimes we use the phrase born digital, referring to content created in a digital environment, on a device like a laptop or a mobile phone, for example. Digital doesn't necessarily mean online. It can be stored locally on a computer or on a physical medium like a CD. Digital also does not imply free. In fact, as we know, digital commerce is an enormous part of the global economy in the 21st century. In the context of education, there are plenty of digital gatekeepers charging for access to learning. While one might agree that there is an important role for commercial entities in education, and most people would probably agree with that this is true, the high cost of access to education, including educational resources, has been one of the driving forces of open education as a movement reducing cost barriers by providing free access. Finally, while the digital nature of open education is usually implied, it is acknowledged that for some learners, physical material is easier to work with. So an open approach works to make it possible for digital resources to be available as print, in the case of a textbook, for example, via services such as print on demand. Lastly, let's look at online. Online refers to materials that are accessible only on the internet. This doesn't tell us anything about what it is, what we can and cannot do with it, or if we will be able to access it without registration or even payment. As much as we are still in the process of making resources available on the internet, making them online, that's only the first step towards open.